Saliva is the fluid present in the oral cavity which is formed by various salivary glands. If we look at the formation of saliva, it occurs in two stages. Structurally speaking, these two stages occur in two different parts of the salivary glands. In the first stage, cells of the secretory end pieces or salivary acini produce saliva which at this stage is known as the primary saliva, which is isotonic. In the second stage, as this saliva travels through the duct system, in striated ducts and excretory ducts, it gets modified, mainly by reabsorption and secretion of electrolytes, such that the final saliva that reaches the oral cavity is hypotonic. First stage. If we look at the composition of saliva, its components can be broadly divided into two categories. First is the macromolecular component and second is the water and electrolytes component. For understanding the formation of primary saliva, we have to look into the secretory end pieces or acini. Salivary acini are made up of numerous pyramidal-shaped cells which have a single nucleus positioned towards the base along with numerous cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparatus. The apex part of the cytoplasm is filled with secretory granules. Neurologic control of saliva secretion. Saliva secretion is mediated through the activity of the autonomic nervous system by both its sympathetic and parasympathetic innervations. The neurotransmitters in the nerve endings stimulates the acinar cells to release their secretory granules containing the macromolecules and secrete water and electrolytes. The molecular events that occur during this process are called stimulus-secretion coupling. Let us take a look at the secretion of the macromolecular component of saliva present in the secretory granules. Firstly, let us study the formation of secretory granules. The cells of the acini have abundant rough endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex. The attached ribosomes synthesize various macromolecules which are then translocated to the lumen of the endoplasmic reticulum for modifications. From here, in small vesicles, these macromolecules are transferred to the Golgi complex where they undergo further modification. From here, these macromolecules are stored in secretory granules in the apical cytoplasm until the cell receives an appropriate secretory stimulus. Now let us see how are these secretory granules released. In the salivary acini, the autonomous nervous system's sympathetic branch releases the neurotransmitter norepinephrine, which binds to the beta adrenergic receptor. This receptor activation in turn activates G protein, which once activated stimulates adenyl cyclase. Adenyl cyclase on stimulation converts ATP into CAMP. CAMP then activates protein kinase A, which in turn phosphorylates various proteins in a cascade that eventually leads to the exocytosis of secretory granules. Exocytosis is the process by which cells release the contents of their secretory granules. This process involves the movement of the secretory granule towards the cell membrane, fusion of the granule membrane with the plasma membrane, followed by the rupture of the fused membranes and release of the macromolecules into the lumen. So that was about the macromolecular component of the saliva. Now let us study about the secretion of water and electrolyte component of saliva. For that, we will first look at the various transporters and channels that play a crucial role. The salivary acinar cell's basal membrane has sodium-potassium ATPase channel, a sodium-potassium 2-chloride co-transporter, and calcium-activated potassium channel. Whereas the apical membrane towards the lumen has calcium-activated chloride channel and water channel called aquaporin. The sodium-potassium ATPase exchanges 3 sodium ions for 2 potassium ions. The sodium-potassium 2-chloride co-transporter transports 1 sodium, 1 potassium and 2 chloride ions into the cell. In the resting state, the cytoplasmic calcium concentration is low because they are stored in cell organelles like rough endoplasmic reticulum, as a result of which the calcium-activated potassium channel is closed and also the calcium-activated chloride channel is not open. Now coming to the secretion of water and electrolytes. Secretion of water and electrolytes is regulated mainly by the parasympathetic innervation. Acetylcholine released from the nerves binds to the muscarinic cholinergic receptor, which activates G protein. Activated G protein in turn activates phospholipase C, which in turn converts phosphatidyl inositol biphosphate in the cytoplasm into diacyl glycerol and inositol triphosphate. Inositol triphosphate subsequently causes the release of calcium from intracellular stores into the cytoplasm. rise in cytoplasmic calcium concentrations opens chloride channels and also the potassium channel. The now open chloride channel transports chloride ions into the acinar lumen, as a consequence of which sodium ions from interstitium cross the intercellular tight junction and reaches the lumen to balance the electrochemical gradient. The osmotic gradient resulting from the increased sodium and chloride ions results in the movement of water into the lumen, mainly through aquaporins. To maintain the electrochemical gradient inside the cell, potassium ions move out through the now open potassium channels. The sodium-potassium 2-chloride cotransporter maintains the continuous inflow of chloride during the active secretion stage. Apart from this mechanism, two alternate mechanisms are known to work based on the same osmotic coupling principle. The first of these mechanisms differs in the chloride entry step. Here, sodium-potassium 2-chloride is replaced by chloride bicarbonate exchanger and a sodium-hydrogen exchanger. The intracellular chloride concentration is maintained by the chloride bicarbonate ion exchanger. The loss of bicarbonate ion is then replenished by the diffusion of carbon dioxide into the cell and its conversion into bicarbonate ion and hydrogen ion by carbonic anhydrase. The hydrogen ion is pumped out by the sodium hydrogen ion exchanger. The other alternate mechanism differs in the chloride exit step. Sodium-potassium 2-chloride channel is replaced only by sodium-hydrogen exchanger. Here, carbon dioxide enters the acinar cell and is converted to bicarbonate ion and hydrogen ion by carbonic anhydrase. Bicarbonate ion itself is secreted to the acinar lumen by the same channel involved in chloride secretion. By studying these processes, it can be inferred that the sympathetic nerve stimulation evokes a protein-rich secretion, whereas the parasympathetic stimulation evokes a large volume of saliva. But this division between parasympathetic and sympathetic control of different aspects of the secretory process is not a clear division, but a blurred one. As sympathetic nerves through norepinephrine also activates alpha adrenergic receptor, which causes release of water and electrolytes. On the other hand, parasympathetic nerves through vasointestinal polypeptide and substance P causes exocytosis of secretory granules. By these processes, the primary saliva is formed in the lumen of the salivary acini. Now coming to the second stage. As this isotonic saliva formed in the acini passes through the striated ducts and excretory ducts, it gets modified, mainly by reabsorption of sodium ions and chloride ions and secretion of bicarbonate ions and potassium ions. There is no movement of water in the duct system. To understand this modification, let us look into the salivary gland duct cells. Sodium ion channels and chloride ion channels are present in both basal membrane and luminal membrane, working for absorption of both the ions. Sodium-potassium ATPase channel present in the basal membrane absorbs sodium and secretes potassium ions. In the luminal membrane, chloride bicarbonate exchanger, potassium hydrogen exchanger, potassium bicarbonate cotransporter and a sodium hydrogen exchanger are present, all working for the absorption of sodium and chloride and secretion of potassium and bicarbonate, thus making the final saliva hypotonic. These ductal modifications depend on the rate of saliva secretion. Slower the saliva secretion, more is the time for ductal modification, more hypotonic the final saliva.